One of the math sections on the ACCUPLACER exam is the arithmetic section. Here I have an example of a type of problem that you might encounter when taking the ACCUPLACER exam. A box is 30 centimeters long, 20 centimeters wide, and 15 centimeters high. What is the volume of the box? On these types of problems, you're going to have to know the formula for volume. And in this case, it's volume of a rectangular prism. The formula is that the volume is the length times the width times the height. So volume is, here's our length, 30 centimeters, times our width, 20 centimeters, times our height, 15 centimeters. Since we're just multiplying three numbers together, you can multiply in any order you want. Remember, though, that you may not get to use a calculator on this type of question on the ACCUPLACER exam. So it's a good idea to practice without a calculator. And then if you get to use one, bonus. So I would start with multiplying 30 times 20. You can do that in your head. 3 times 2 is 6. And then you have the two zeros, so that's 600 times 15. So we have 600 centimeters times centimeters is centimeters squared times 15 centimeters. And then we can go off to the side and multiply those together. And I would actually put the 15 on top. I know it looks kind of weird. People don't normally multiply like that. They usually like to put the bigger number on top. But since 600 just has these two zeros, that's all we're going to do with those, and then you just multiply 6 times 5 is 30, carry your 3, 6 times 1 is 6, plus 3 is 9, and there we have our answer, 9,000. So the volume is 9,000 centimeters squared times centimeters is centimeters cubed. 9,000 centimeters cubed. Here's an example of an arithmetic question that you might see when you take the ACCUPLACER exam. The ACCUPLACER exam has an entire arithmetic section. Arithmetic just means simple math. Here's an example of one type of problem that you may encounter when you take the ACCUPLACER exam. 6 and 32 hundredths minus 3 and 5 tenths. You need to be prepared to do these types of questions without a calculator. What's important when subtracting or even adding decimals is that you line up the decimals. So, 6 and 32 hundredths minus 3 and 5 tenths. You can add a zero behind the 5 so that everything's all even. What I like to do with decimals when I'm adding them or subtracting them is just think about money. So we're taking $6.32 and subtracting $3.50. Sometimes it's helpful to come up with an estimate in your head before you actually subtract. We have 6 minus 3.5, just rounding it, or even 6 minus 4. Your answer then should be somewhere around 2, which means that D, this answer is way too high. We already know that, just from estimating what the answer might be. Now we're ready to subtract. 2 minus 0 is 2. You can't take 5 from 3, so you need to borrow from the 6, which makes it a 5. And then you give 10 to the 3, so that's 13 now. 13 minus 5 is 8. Bring down your decimal. And 5 minus 3 is 2. So our answer was somewhere around 2, 2 and 82 hundredths, and that is almost 3. And there's our answer A. And there you have one example of an arithmetic question that you could see on an ACCUPLACER exam. One of the math sections on the ACCUPLACER exam is the arithmetic section. On the arithmetic section, you're going to be tested on basic math. So you need to be prepared to answer these questions without a calculator. One of the skills you're going to be tested on is being able to multiply fractions, which is what this question addresses. Says, what is 5/6 of 3/4? The first thing you need to know is that that word of means to multiply. So we can rewrite this as 5/6 times 3/4. And there's more than one way to do this problem. The first way is simply just to multiply straight across and then simplify your answer. 5 times 3 is 15, 6 times 4 is 24, and then simplify that fraction, meaning divide your numerator and denominator by the same number. Both of these numbers are divisible by 3. 15 divided by 3 is 5, and 24 divided by 3 is 8. There's your answer for multiplying those fractions. That's one way to multiply your fractions. Another way to multiply your fractions is to cross-cancel before multiplying. It's really like simplifying before you multiply instead of multiplying and then simplifying. So let's see how that would work. In this case, we can cross-cancel our 3 and our 6 because they're both divisible by 3. Just like we simplified this fraction by dividing numerator and denominator by 3, we're going to divide this numerator and denominator by 3. 3 divided by 3 is 1. 6 divided by 3 is 2. And now you multiply straight across just like we did before. 5 times 1 is 5, and 2 times 4 is 8. So you see they yield the same result. And it's really up to you to choose which method you prefer. Either way, though, we get 5/8 for our answer. And there you have an example of multiplying fractions, which is a skill you'll need when you take the ACCUPLACER exam. One of the sections on the ACCUPLACER exam is the arithmetic section. On this section, you'll need to use scratch paper and not a calculator. So, you gotta have some basic math skills. Here's one example of the type of problem you're gonna see on the arithmetic section of the ACCUPLACER exam. Which of the following is equivalent to 27/8? 27/8 is an improper fraction. And when you look at the answer choices, you can see that they're all mixed numbers. So to turn an improper fraction into a mixed number, all you have to do is divide. And I like to say, this is just like a little way that I remember, and I know that sounds silly because, right, we should know how to divide, but this is how I remember how to divide my numbers. I say top in, bottom out. And what that means is when you're dividing, the top number goes inside and the bottom number goes outside. It's just like a cute little way to remember where to put your numbers because you can't get the right answer if you're putting those in the wrong place to begin with. So first we need to figure out how many times 8 goes into 27. And that's 3 times. 8 times 3 is 24. You subtract and you get 3 as your remainder. Now, if we were trying to get a decimal, then we would keep going. We'd add a decimal and a zero, we'd bring that down, we'd keep dividing till we got a remainder of zero. But we're not trying to get a decimal, we're trying to get a mixed number. And to write a mixed number, you stop at the remainder. You take that remainder and use it to make your fraction. The remainder is your numerator, and the divisor is your denominator. That's it, 3 3/8. So there you have one example of an arithmetic problem that you might encounter on the ACCUPLACER exam. One of the math sections on the ACCUPLACER exam is the arithmetic section. Here I have an example of an arithmetic question that you might see when you're taking your ACCUPLACER exam. It says 9.5% of the people in a town voted for a certain proposition in a municipal election. If the town's population is 51,623, about how many people in the town voted for the proposition? This word about is really helpful. It means that our problem just got a lot easier because we don't have to use 9.5%. We can round 9.5% to 10%. And we don't have to use 51,623. We can round that to 50,000. Makes our numbers a lot simpler. So 10% of the 50,000 people in the town voted for the proposition. And that's what we're trying to figure out. What's the 10%? You can use the percent equation if equations are helpful to you. The percent equation is the part equals the percent times the whole. And in this case, we know the percent and we know the whole. We have the whole town's population and we know the percent that voted for the proposition. What we are looking for is, what was that part? How many people voted for it? So the part is equal to, now even though it says percent, you actually can't use the percent there because we don't calculate with percents. You either have to write your percent as a fraction or as a decimal. And in this case, since I'm multiplying this percent times my whole, the 50,000, it would be helpful to write the percent as a fraction. Be a little bit easier, and I'll show you why. 10%, and that word per cent literally means the per is divided by, and cent is the prefix for century, or it means 100. Cent means 100. And you've heard it in words like century. So it means per 100. So that's actually 10 per cent, written as a fraction, times the whole, which is 50,000. And then we put that over 1 since we're multiplying it times a fraction. Now, I told you I wanted to write it as a fraction because it'd be easier when multiplying by 50,000. The reason for that is because you can cross-cancel these two zeros in each one of your numbers. So then you just have 10 times 500. 10 times 500, multiplying by 10, just moves that decimal one place to the right. So it adds another zero in this case, gives you 5,000. Which, and this is like the real mathy way to do it, but if you think about it, 10% is just a tenth of 50,000, and a tenth of 50,000 would be 5,000. There you have one example of an arithmetic type question that you might encounter on the ACCUPLACER exam.